told me you were drowning, I would not lend a hand. I've seen your face before, my friend, but you don't know who I know who I am. Well, I was there and I saw what you did. I saw it with my own two eyes. But you can wipe off that grin, know where you've been. It's all been a pack of lies. The last time we ever met. But I know the reason why you keep your silence up. No, you don't fool me. Well, the hurt doesn't show, but the pain still grows. It's no stranger to you and me.
Tonight. You made it out. Woo! 20 degrees, it don't matter. It's hot in here. So, alright, so I want to just give a little backstory. A lot of this new show that I'm doing, I've kind of been, if you've been following my career, it's been a little crazy, and I've been kind of everywhere. And I decided I want to go back to my roots a little bit and just do things that I like to do. And that's why this show is called My Favorite Things. It's a little nod to the Hammerstein show I did. But in reality, I just picked the songs I really liked, and I'm just singing them and having fun and giving them to you guys and kind of telling the stories why these songs that I've assembled are really very, very important to me and how they've kind of made me grow as an artist and the inspiration, and I'll kind of give you a little journey into my madness as we go along. But just to start, Phil Collins is one of my favorite of all time. So I just had to open with him, and that's one of my favorite songs of all time. So this next song that we're gonna do is brand new. It's a new song. When I was in second grade, I bought my very first cassette tape with my own money, and it was this artist, and this song was on that album. So I said I have to include it. And now that I moved to the state that he is famous from, which is Jersey, I kind of have to represent that too. Let's do a little Bon Jovi. Yeah.
She says we gotta hold on to what we've got. It doesn't make a difference if we make it or not. We got each other, and that's a lot for love. We'll give it a shot.
Was very important to me when I was in high school. I went up to Toronto to see a show with my mother and my grandmother, and we went to see Phantom of the Opera. And I was sitting there and watching Christine sing all the high notes, and I was fascinated by that. I was just mesmerized. It's probably the thing that got me into music, was listening and seeing that show. So as much as people don't like Andrew Lloyd Webber that much, it sure helped me a lot. But I really just enjoyed seeing it. And when Christine kept going up for the higher notes, higher notes, higher notes, I turned to my mother and I said, "Mom, I can do that." And she looked at me and said, "Yeah, okay." So she bought me the cast recording when we left, and Cole Wilkinson was on it. He was incredible. And also bought me the karaoke tracks, because I just, you know, wanted to have them. So I was very shy, and I didn't want to sing in front of anybody, so nobody really knew I could sing. And one day my mother went out to go do something. I thought everybody was gone, so I put in karaoke tracks, and I'm singing my head off. And she forgot something, comes back in, and hears me singing, and she's like, "Oh my God, I think she can do that." So the next day, she says, maybe, you know, teachers have been kind of saying, get her lessons. So finally, she decided to get me lessons. And we had a piano. Piano tuner came. Random guy out of the phone book comes to the house and says, she's like, "I'm thinking of getting my daughter voice lessons. Do you know anyone? Can you recommend anybody? We don't know." And he's like, "Well, here's my voice teacher." And he was an opera singer. So he pulls out this card right then and there. And it was like serendipitous. We called her up, met with her once. I sang for her. She called me a freak. In a good way. Well, maybe. Yet to be determined. But that I had a 3.5 octave range, and I needed to pursue it. And so the rest is history. Went to college, started auditioning for schools, and this show is the reason why.
There you go.
So here's a little think of me from Phantom.
Thank you.
A little something different. That's me, eclectic. That's my middle name. Thank you. This next tune is sort of bridging the gap for my next step in my journey. I crossed over at some point to country and started out doing some other things, but as we'll examine. But this really marries musical theater, opera, southern rock, and me. Little Porgy and Bess, Summertime.
Baby, don't you cry.
take a little summertime right now. I'd light the candles, but I already have enough. Do the lighter. I think that's why it's so hot here. Set off the fire detectors. All right, this next tune is a familiar one. Hopefully, they're all familiar, but this one's more so. This was when I decided to get out of opera, get out of music theater. I became a DJ and I did a one-woman show where I used to sing, DJ, dance, do a lot of things. And it was mostly done, I became like the sweetheart of Atlantic City when Atlantic City was good. And I used to play like Trump, Taj Mahal, and Trump Plaza. And he didn't own it. And just did a whole bunch of shows. I did a 10-week contract there, and this became one of the populars of the show that I did, so I had to include it. And plus, it's just a fun damn song, so let's go.
There's cold in the night that shines from you. You wind like the wreck you hide behind the mask you use. Did you think this fool would never win? Look at me, I'm coming back again. Got a taste of love in a simple way. You need to know while I'm standing, you just fade away. Don't you know I'm still standing better than I ever did? Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little. Don't you know I'm still standing better than I ever did? Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. Well, I'm still standing after all this time. Picking up the pieces of my life without you on my mind. I'm still standing.
Don't slack on me now.
I'm still standing. Don't you know I'm still standing better than I ever did? Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. Well, I'm still standing after all this time. Picking up the pieces of my life without you on my mind. I'm still standing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Don't you love that? It smells alright. My breath is okay, right?
Yes.
Yes.
It smells good. Yeah, you can attest. It smells alright.
Yeah.
That song is sort of a testament to who I am. I'm still standing after all this time, my God. And in these, you're pretty tall. Alright, I need some water. Alright. Now, we're going to hear a little bit of stuff that I've written now. And like I said, I crossed over to country music and wrote my first album, and it was sort of... You can write music to make money, you can be famous, you can do all that crap, and you know what, as I get older, really not important. What's important is making an impact in someone's life, even if it's one person, that really made a difference because you did this, you wrote this song. And this song became my favorite. It was my favorite, and it became even more of my favorite because of that. So this is Over. I still hear voices echoing inside my head, over and over like a song. I still see your face staring back at me, over and over like a movie. When the world is crumbling down, I look for you. Songs, and he always says, I have to do it, and I have to do it. So I've done it twice now, and he hasn't come. Bought tickets, but he doesn't show up. You tell him. But I don't care. I like the tune anyway. I used to end my huge country southern rock, it was rock and roll. I used to end my song and my show with this tune. This was the encore of that show. So yeah, let's add it in there. This is a little Alnana Miles and Black Velvet. Well, see, that was the end of my show. And last time, everybody was like dying for an encore. So I made an encore. I have an encore. But you guys gotta give me some love if you want me to encore.
On his heart. Whoa, 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 whoa. I'll get him high, show him what I've got. Whoa, 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 whoa. I'll get him hot, show him what I got. Show him what I got.